Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's down 85, NASDAQ up 31, S&P's are up 1 point. And let's go to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, and we are going to ride this wave. And we're talking about each and every day we're at new all-time highs. Our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, folks, is going to be doing a great webinar tonight, 5 to 6:30 Eastern Standard Time, for all subscribers. Now, it's very easy to be a subscriber, folks. You can come over at TFNN. You're going to go right under featured content. You're going to see the opening call by our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. You can subscribe for 1 month, which is $128. 6 months, which is $595, which is a savings of $173. A year, which is $995, which is a savings of $541. Now, the way this works, folks, is that they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what the deal is when you're looking at these newsletters is that you can get the newsletter for a month. You can get a 30-day money-back guarantee. You can commit to a workshop tonight that's going to be outstanding. And then on top of that, Basil has five other workshops that are archived inside your page. If you can't make it, you're doing something from 5 to 6:30 tonight, guess what? We have some great technology. It's archived. It can be on your page. You can go over it as many times as you like. And I'm going to let our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, explain what he is going to be speaking about tonight. I got my surfboard, man. I better have my surfboard, man.
I hope you got your you've got your covering on because it's kind of cold out there for a surfboard.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. There's no doubt about that.
So this is going to be a very timely workshop because I usually like to time the workshops where I think there's a chance of some kind of a turn in the market. This one is going to be very tough, and one of the reasons is some of the moving averages, some of the technicals that I'm showing. If you look at this chart on the left here,
okay,
what I'm going to be discussing tonight, look at the MACD, it's still very strong.
Yeah.
I love to say that the stochastic above 80% is very good. The textbooks would say in technical analysis, over 80% is overbought. I like it overbought. I actually want to see it in the 90, but at 97.78%, just 1.23% off 100%, which it never reaches, this is starting to get stretched. And the on-balance volume that I use here as a timing tool looks to me like it's a little overbought. And yet, even with Home Depot down 12 points, the Dow is only down 82 points in the S&P's holding. So the buying here is very intense, and that makes me, and this is what's so important about tonight's webinar, I'm going to be going. I'm going to be showing different time frames. And the time frame in the daily says, yep, it's getting a bit toppy. The weekly chart is just starting to bump into resistance, and the monthly chart is good. And I'll just show this just for a second because I will be talking about it tonight. The Chapman wave always trying to identify a low bar, and from that low bar, you've got at least four successively higher peaks, alphabetized, then peak A, then peak B, then higher C, and then peak D. You can go all the way to E, F, and G, but at D, other things can happen. We've seen that. I've shown you the dollar chart, et cetera, where the Ds were so important. But I also need to look at a straight line move down or up, and then a cup formation, and an arch formation. And then there's a pattern I call the dreaded H, the lowercase h, where if you take out the left side low in a little arch formation, it's very poor. And if you take out the right side on the right, if you take out the left side high, that's good. So three patterns, straight line, cup, and arch, how you put them together, moving averages that I use. And the most important thing is time sequences. And within that context, I'm going to show how from opening call subscribers, we've got quite a few stocks that have done really well using these particular techniques. I'm going to show the techniques live. I'm also going to show something that I think is going to be quite important. It is the relationship of the different sectors, and that even within a sector, you know, I've often talked about it. I call it an index. It's not. It's called CASH, C-A-S-H. That has Cintas, Amazon, SPY, and Home Depot.
Okay.
Well, three of those are not doing very well. SPY's at an all-time high. Today hit an all-time high. Cintas is down, not sharply, but it's down way off its high. Home Depot just got smacked. And you've got Amazon, which at this particular time of the year should be soaring. And look, there it is down. So I'm going to be talking about relationships and trying to pick stocks, identifying them, how it can really help you if you can get the stocks right, because they can, for instance, we have a stock, we have one particular stock, BDSI. This is Biodelivery Sciences. I use the cup formation. I'm going to teach that. I use the kind of a fulcrum in the middle to say that in the month of December, should try for the 6.40 area. It hit the 6.45. We're in at $5.17. It's at peak D and still holding well, still holding these moving averages of importance. Leg D in the monthly. It's a pattern I call the cup, Chapman wave cup and ladle. It's, you know, the handle is where you stop at the left side. And you make a little handle, and then you break to the upside. This cup and ladle is very powerful. Doesn't stop. It goes right through the left side high. And that's very, very, that creates a move that should take you to that fourth highest peak, peak D. These are all things that folks can do without necessarily knowing all my notations. These are patterns. I want them to recognize the patterns. I want them to be able to decipher what, how to use moving averages, different time frames. So it's really, it's a workshop, and then they can also use four other workshops. At least three of them are really pertinent to what we're looking at. One is called The Tide. It's looking at how you can use certain indicators to suggest that you can go from a short term to an intermediate term to a longer term move. We've done that in the dollar. We did that when we bought it in April of 2018. So these are, this is a very important time. And I am going to talk about what we would look for on any downturn here and what the breakout to new highs means since we're in leg D in the monthly chart of the Dow. So this is really timely. It's very functional. I want people to come out and say, wow. You know, sometimes you go to a workshop and you nod your head and you think you understand everything. And as you step out of it, you say, whoa, whoa, wait, what am I going to do next? This tells you exactly what you're going to do tomorrow. So, and also, of course, they get my daily newsletter. So but tomorrow they will get the information pertinent to what happens the very next day. Sure. So I'm looking forward to it.
No, big time. You know what's intriguing, Basil, is that the when you look at the transports on the small caps, right? You know, both of these folks, they topped out, and the small caps topped out in July of 2018.
They're not confirming.
And the transports topped out in September of 2018. It's so intriguing, man. I mean, because it's like, you know, we know we're at all-time highs, but bottom line is that I can't seem to remember a time in the last 30 years that you're that far off one major indice. Do you know what I'm saying?
And I'll be talking tonight about that very thing. The 30 years, I'm actually going back even more than that, and I'm saying I just don't recall ever a time where it's such a quiet, silent, stealth bull market.
Yeah.
Nobody's talking about the stock market. You know, anytime you go to new highs for 3-4 months in a row over the years, you would have people everywhere saying, man, did I make a fortune? But I think one of the things that's most important, stock splits. You've got really expensive stocks. The folks are not talking about the hot stocks as if they've gone, you know, from 15 to 45. And then even the cannabis stocks, which were hot, are not hot anymore. We had the Bitcoin. So they've been bitten and hit quite hard when the general lay public has gone into these fads. So I must say, looking out, I have to be very bullish to see this quietness in the market. That doesn't mean to say we can't get sharp pullbacks, but I think that's a bullish sign.
No, listen, all you have to do is say there's a trade deal and the market will go up 500 points.
I mean, right.
You know.
And say it again and again and again.
Yeah. Folks, come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go right into featured content. Subscribe to the opening call right now. You will not regret it, and you're just absolutely going to love it. Basil, we look forward to the workshop in an hour and a half.
Thank you so much, Tom.
Thank you.
Speak to you soon.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back.